Alright, what's going on, boys? We got the worst duelist here. We got some gameplay that doesn't actually feature me. I guess Jad wasn't very happy with his role. I'm going to just be honest with you guys. They literally did that. They just rolled that die for like, easy like 15 minutes. So I've actually had to quite heavily edit this video because of all the fuckery and degeneracy. Literally starting with this fucking Dark Magician Girl Field Center Orica magic card. But yeah, they just, yeah, see, so we have just Dre just looking at his opponent's entire deck. So yeah, I guess from there you could have saw that, you know, Jad's playing Infernoble. They literally didn't even have to roll the die. See, they're still going. I don't understand. But eventually they'll draw their hands of five. Yeah, I just don't get it. obviously Jad's handshake there gets denied. You'll see Dre here is playing Dogmaitka Invoked. Eldlich, his hand is fucking atrocious. It is what, double flirtly, double meltdown punishment, and then Jad's just literally just gonna sit here and just go maximum full combo on him. Zold here, you know, we had the Fire Flint and the what's it called? Dolphin searching connector here, sending four, going for probably Armageddonite because
yep, armor loops, yep.
So we got that going for us at least. We got Link Cross shenanigans here. We're going for Plague. Going for the Fiber. We're going to get Vylon Sphere here. And then we're going to go like Formula, climb up into Auroradon, I think. I don't remember. This combo is actually kind of similar to the combo video that is featured on my channel. It's actually two or three videos ago. But anyway, we have Dre summoning this Flirtily here because he has the other copy in his hand. So he's trying to get the Flirtily out before Jed has negates so that, you know, at some point he may be able to use the other one next turn. So it's pretty smart on his end to summon it now. So anyway, we got the Marcher, we're going to get back Sphere, we're going to go into Captain Roland, we're going to get Renaud, we're going to add DDR. He's just really just going to Happy Funland here. But yeah, like I was saying, if you want to check out the one card combo that he wanted to post on my channel, it's basically no Coltwing, no Deskbot 001, no Power Tool, one DDR instead of three. And then it's a double hand rip, and then the same board of Charles Harold Savage. But yeah, we're going to see him do that here. He does not get the double hand rip, though. Maybe he could have. I'm not even too sure if he had thought of that at this point. This footage is actually like 2 weeks old. I'm just really late on uploading it here. But we got Plague coming back again for the fucking Uptillion time off that DDR, and then we have a Savage, and then we're just gonna use the Auroradon here and then pop the Flirtily, which is unfortunate for Dre, but yeah, you know, again, it's literally just Jad's unconventional bullshit. It's just, yeah, just dumb. But hey, I mean, I guess it works. It definitely does get him there, doing this sort of just different routes that he takes, and then we have the smoke ripping the punishment because that's the only thing we're truly, truly worried about here. So we got a meltdown, we're gonna get an Alistar, we're gonna get impermed, we're gonna go Almirage, Secure Gardener, set a back row pass. I believe the back row is a Scarlet Sanguine. But yeah, this has just gone terribly for Dre the whole time. Just absolutely awful. The opening hand was shit. Oh, we're going to summon the Flirtily. I believe we're going to end up negating with Harold. Because that does, in fact, activate in hand. Yeah, we're negating with Harold, and we're going to set one back row. So, I mean, at any rate, he did pseudo start clearing up the board there. But we're going to get this Charles Poppian phase on the back row. It was a Conquistador, not a Scarlet Sanguine. So he's going to banish. And I believe we're going to go ahead and trigger that. I'm not sure. Summoning Gearfreed, and that's a big old fat scoop. So we're going into game two here. Jad's cutting like he's probably cheating. And then I believe that Dre just Oh, no, he doesn't do the same. Yeah, here we go. We got some more gypsy cuts on Jad's end. Yeah, no, now he's copying him. take the top off the bottom. Take the top, move it to the bottom for the fat trolls. so we have Dre going first here. If I remember right, this hand really just isn't much better at all. So we have Nadir, Ecclesia. I think it's like double Golden Lord, and this one has Scarlet Sanguine. So we're going to get, we're going to get impermed is what we're going to get. And then the end phase, we're going to go ahead and search up our additional Ecclesia to try to do something next turn. But yeah, I'm not really too sure what the problem is, but it seems like every time that Dre here just plays Jad, Jad just goes fucking off the deep end and just goes crazy. Fucking Dre bricks so hard. It's quite entertaining actually to watch. Just because of just like, I don't know, it's just funny. It's just because it happens every time. Maybe it's just because I know them, but yeah, it makes me laugh. Just can't catch a break. So we see the Fire Flint effect being activated. That's actually something that happens quite rarely. Gets the Silent Boots out so he can start trying to go into Phantom Knight memes here. I think he ends up cutting the Phantom Knight stuff in later builds. I'm going to have his deck profile up here probably Thursday or Friday. I'm not sure. I'll try. Saturday at the latest, the profile will be up. I'm kind of just backlogged on just gameplay and just things in general. And like I said, this is like 2 weeks old at this point. I just never got around to it. But yeah, we see him doing the standard kind of stuff here. Send four for Arma. Damn, I'm not sure how that Oliver got there. I was reviewing this footage earlier, and I just completely... I keep looking away when that Oliver comes... I think it's equipped. Yeah, that's right. That's the meme. He equipped Oliver here for literally no reason to his old. And Dre's like, what the fuck, you did that? And Jad's like, you know what? Just because. Because fuck it. And it's funny because later he tries to use Oliver. And Dre's like, nah, you already did that, you fucking idiot. So we got Plague coming down. We got Fiber. We got Violent Sphere again. Oh, man. We got Captain Roland. We got Captain Roland. Yeah, we got a sphere coming to equip. We're gonna use sphere effect. We're gonna add back Durandal. We're gonna play Durandal. We're gonna go find ourselves a singular fire boy. We're gonna special this Renard. We're gonna add the DDR. Oh my god, he's going off the deep end, boys. And they're coming round the back stretch. We're gonna summon back the Arma Knight. Yep, Arma Loops. Yep. Gonna send the Zephyros. We're gonna bounce the DDR. Oh my god! And then, yeah, I think this is Charles here. And then we're gonna work on getting towards Auroradon, of course. My boy Dre is kind of just like, bruh, why you did that? I think the Fleur-de-Lis on the Linkross was correct, just because now Jad has had to use more resources out of hand. But it's just like, the way he's designed the deck with the Arma Loops trying to, you know, go on here. And this is where he goes Oliver, and Dre's like, oh, yep, you can go fuck yourself. But the way he's designed the deck with, like, the Arma Loop type deal here, it kind of just... Sure, he'll deplete more resources out of his hand, but now, like, the Arma Knight is just going to generate so much advantage. And, like, the DDR and the Phoenix Blade are just... That combo is just too good. It's not really a combo. I guess it's a combo. But we got access code, pop the board. We got swing for not enough damage because we're going to flip up a Scarlet Sanguine and we're going to go ahead and get our Golden Boy. There's smack over with access code, set two cards, and give it back to Dre. I think end phase resolving Captain Roland for this and Ogier, and then, you know, Charles. Maybe the Charles was the Ogier, yeah. This is Ogier from deck, and then we get the Ecclesia out of hand, I guess. And then we're going to go draw, set a card. Yeah, it's pretty unfortunate. There's just not really a ton he can do here. I mean, it's like, I know that Jad has, like, no negates, but... what did he send it? He sent it to Grave, maybe, with Golden Lord? I don't know. Oh, no, maybe that was the Hecaro? It looked like he just said it. He did just say it, didn't he? I don't know, but we're going to set two back row. I don't know what these fucking cards do, to be honest with you. I'm very unfamiliar with the Eldlich archetype, so, yeah, sorry, you really got nothing for you there. but yeah, he said it's the grave, and then we have a Conquistador, it looks like. I think that's another Scarlet Sanguine on the other side. And then we're going to get the Golden Boy out, and then we're going to try to just wall up here, try to make something happen so we can draw into one of our fucking seven Alistairs, which is another thing I don't understand about this deck. You know, it's like you play so much search power, and he opens the way he opened, so it's just, what the fuck? So we got a Gear Free here, we got a normal summon of a connector. We just always have it, I guess, whenever we're Jad Andrew playing the 60-card Spice, the Wario mashup. But yeah, got a Heritage here, just for solidifying shit even more. But this is what's cool about playing Dre. He just really never scoops. I feel like he's definitely one of those guys that's like, I'm not really dead until my life points are at zero, or I'm not really dead until I have literally one card in hand and you have four negates. But we see more DDR looping. What the hell? Whose man is this? Now we're going to go into a Savage Herald play with a Gearfried. And that is probably going to end up creating that game state of, I have one card in hand and you have three negates, but, you know, and the Herald is a pseudo floodgate. I wonder what his back row is. I feel like, oh man, I feel like knowing Jad, he's got fucking double imperm back there. It could just be straight up bluffs, though. I would not put that past him either. But, yeah, we're equipping access code of all fucking things. Isn't that broken? So we're going to attack Golden Lord, we're going to equip the Conquistador, we're going to attack for, what is it, like 4,000 something with the Savage. That's access code 25, so it's like 4,250, something like that. So a smack with that, and then, yeah, I think he's dead, I don't remember. Or maybe he's got something here in grave. I don't remember. It looks like he drew for turn, I'm not sure. Maybe I thought he only had he had two cards in hand. I thought he only had one. But yeah, I guess that's going to be a wrap here. Not really a whole ton Dre could have done. At any rate, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if you haven't. That whole bit. Like I said, I'm going to have updated deck lists for Jad. I want to get a deck list from Dre on the channel, but he just has so many piles of cardboard. I'm not sure if he just can't decide, or maybe he just doesn't even want to do one, but I digress. So I guess I'll catch you next time, simps.